September has lived up to its billing as a weak month for stocks, and getting back into sustained rally mode may take some time. In the recent weeks, we have seen that the stock market has decreased on September, and it's due to the simplest of reasons. Tech stocks such as Amazon, Apple, Netflix, and Tesla had powerful gains in the summer and had to come back down to earth. In short, big tech companies is now viewed a bigly overvalued stock. Investing in a stock market requires most active investors to distinguish between undervalued or undervalued stocks in order to achieve great and consistent returns. Hi there, welcome to Investor's Game. Today, we're gonna talk about how to avoid investing in overvalued stocks. And give us a thumbs up, you know, that helps us a lot, so let's get started. First of all, what does really mean if a stock is undervalued or overvalued? Have you ever heard of the famous saying, buy low and sell high? This rule makes sense, but it's more difficult to accomplish than it may seem. If everyone was able to buy a stock when the prices were low and sell as soon as they turn high, there would be a lot of more successful investors, and investing will be a child's play. Buying low and selling high essentially means buying undervalued stocks and selling them when they become overvalued. The price alone won't tell you much about the value of the stock. You need to put the price into perspective with other important characteristics of your investment. In this case, the business that lies behind each stock. So, in order to determine if a stock is undervalued or overvalued, we need to analyze the fundamental value of underlying business and decide whether the current stock price justifies those fundamentals or not. Also, we have mentioned before why big technology stock is now viewed as overvalued. It's for this simple reason. If we check Tesla stock, this year has gained more than 400%, and that's a crazy number. And when these kind of things happen in the market, usually the stock means that it's in a bubble or overvalued, and every time that its price increases, the bubble is getting bigger, causing more risk in the stock. And for many reasons, investors believe that tech companies now are in a bubble. And all of these are in a fair explanation for an across-the-board sell-off in stocks. Stocks never go up in a straight line forever. Now there's a disconnect between Wall Street and what's happening in the economy, where jobless are in the millions and the recession may not be over anytime soon. Along the way, many stocks are rising and trading at ever more expensive valuation. This price could make them vulnerable if there's a correction, which at this point seems inevitable. Cannopy Growth, Tesla, Apple, and IPO stocks such as Snowflake are great examples of how stocks you should steer clear of right now. Cannopy Growth? Shares are down 23% in 2020. For a normal stocks, that might be a bad news. For a Canadian cannabis stocks, however, that's an average. The Orange and Marijuana Life Science ETF is down by a similar amount this year. Cannopy Growth, however, has been falling out of favor with investors for a while, now because of its poor results. In its more recent earnings report, released August 10 for the first quarter ending July 3rd, its net sales of $110 million Canadian dollars were up a modest 22% year over year. Management has referred to the current fiscal year as much transition year, which is a clear indication that investors shouldn't be expecting too much. Cannopy Growth's new CEO, who came from Constellation Brands, which has invested in more than $4 billion, this year is looking to clean up the strength of the company's financial. Cannopy Growth has reported an operating loss in each year of the past 5 years, and those losses have been growing in size along the way. Also, we made a video about cannabis stocks. If you haven't watched it, I'll leave the link in the description. Cannopy Growth prices needs to fall more before the stock can be a good buy. When compared to its Canadian peers, its shares price to sales PS ratio indicates that it's grossly overvalued. In this chart, we can see how this stock is overvalued, and compared to the other stocks related to cannabis, this is way farther to be to the fair price. But how these companies lose money if big investors keep putting money into the market? Because cannabis stocks are still in development, there's no guarantee that cannabis will keep being legalized around the world. Cannopy Growth has seen its financial losses expand dramatically in recent years as it sacrificed profits to grow in the marijuana sector. On the other hand, Tesla has become one of the year's hottest stocks after the electric car manufacturer finally delivered profit to its shareholders. In the second quarter of 2020, the company's gross margin improved by 649%, This was Tesla's fourth consecutive quarter of profitability. However, investors are essentially betting that there is a 100% chance Tesla's new production facilities in Germany and the US will align with customers' demand. Right now, Tesla can produce 690,000 Model SX and Model 3Y vehicles per year. While it only delivered 388,000 cars in the last 12 months, Tesla gets it wrong and overestimates consumer enthusiasm for electric cars. So Tesla can't keep predicting how many cars that they can sell for the next year. It will have invested millions of dollars into the factories at a considerable loss. Given the valuation, that sounds like a huge risk to take. Investors have a lot to lose and little to gain if they buy Tesla after its spectacular rally this year. Also, at the beginning, we mentioned about stay away from IPO stocks. But recently, a stock called Snowflake has become an IPO, and Warren Buffett was one of the first investors to put money into the stock. Berkshire Hathaway is set to invest roughly $570 billion, but this bet on Snowflake is surprising because Warren Buffett has avoided technology stocks for most of his career, preferred to stay within his circle of competence and investing in companies he understands. Buffett and Charlie Munger, his business partner, have long avoided IPOs and warning investors against participating in them. Buffett highlighted the hype around IPOs and strong incentives to drive up their prices as compelling reasons to stay away. Buffett also said at Berkshire's 2004 annual meetings that the timing of IPO tends to favor the company, not its new investors. The seller decides when to come to market in most cases, he said. They don't think peak at times necessarily that's good for you. When considered a market undervalue or undervalue, always is good to know the difference between price and value. Warren Buffett once said, "Price is what you paid, value is what you get." This one may seem obvious, but it's one of the most important things to understand about investing in general. There's a distinctive difference between price and value, and not every stock's price will always reflect the true value of each stock. For example, as of September 2020, Netflix is currently trading at around $493 per share. Let's suppose that the stock price will suddenly jump to the sky the next day. Instead of $493, one share of Netflix will now be trading at $2,000 per share. If absolutely nothing has changed within the company or any factor outside the business, would you consider it buy the stocks? Or would a price of $2,000 per share just seem too ridiculous to you for what the company's current offers? If you wouldn't be willing to pay $2,000 for the stock, how much would you pay if you had the choice? Would it be $250, $150, or $50 for one share? Regardless of the price that you choose for yourself, that price point would be what investors call fair value. The fair value of a stock is essentially the price that you personally think the stock is worth right now. In order to determine if a stock is undervalued or overvalued, you need to analyze the stock fundamental characteristics relative to the current market price. Also, we made a video about how to pick stocks where we talk about different ratios to use and how we can determine our intrinsic value. We will leave the link in the description. So finally, one approach of assessing a stock's value is using different metrics ratio and comparing them between different companies and stock records. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button. Let me know in the comment box, would you invest in the stock market right now or would you wait for a better opportunity? Subscribe to my channel because every week I'm in YouTube with new content, and do not forget to activate the bell so you don't miss any of our videos. See you next time.